If p is a member of s, p square is a member of s, yes, any number that ends with a 5, its square will also end with a 5, no matter what the other digits are. So yes, if p is a member of s, p square is also going to be a member of s, that's correct. Look at statement 2. Same with 6 also, I must have taken that case also. If a number ends with 6, 6 square also ends with a 6. So all such numbers are going to be a part of the set. Look at the second one. Again, this is also going to be fine because it's not only the square, all the powers of 5, see 5 cube, 5 raised to power 4, all of them will end up with a 5. Same with 6, 6, 36, 216, 1296, all the numbers are ending with a 6, and therefore this is also going to be alright. Nothing can be said about square root p because of course there are numbers which end with a 5 and are not perfect squares. For example, 5 itself, root 5, is not going to be a member of the set, whereas 5 is a member of the set, and root 6, similarly 6 is a member of the set, but root 6 will not be a member of the set. So must be cannot be set, and therefore it's only 1 and 2. C is the right answer.